In this world, opposites attract. Chocolate and cheese, Mackey's chips in a McFlurry, vanilla Coke, all things you would never imagine working out. But actually, when together, they create utter magic.
Living in Spain! Sex machine.
Christmas.
Danny King, Billy Brothenstankle, and Steve Oxo put together can be a bit uncomfortable. The Bouncy Castles are synonymous with fame, success, controversies, and of course, Billy. Well, it all started with a chance meeting. Aww, cute.
Yeah, it all happened by chance, really. I did two other courses before jumping on media, and I wanted to do media before then, but I didn't have the qualifications, and if I'd have done it by then, I wouldn't have met any of them. So yeah, mad how that happened.
I remember Danny once told me he's ever been scared three times in his life. Once when he was born, secondly when he first used the SodaStream, and the third time when he thought he saw Bin Laden in Argos. You know one of those small dogs you get? Like when you go around your nana's house, it's like a small yappy dog. And you know when it starts in your leg and it can't believe it gets away with it? That's Billy.
They're a lovely bunch of lads. Love them all. They're brilliant.
I would have loved to have strangled the little
Surprisingly, they didn't start off as friends. In fact, if not for a certain person, the threesome never would have happened. Threesome? Really? Threesome. With Marvin Darling as the front man, the band got its start. Yes, that's right, the band didn't start as the Bouncy Castles, and the band didn't start with the three members.
Marvin came up to me with the idea of being in a band. He's so musically talented. So Danny and Steve as well. Brilliant, so talented. God, I do love those boys.
It was alright at first, you know, making a bit of music between college work and half terms and stuff like that. It was all good, you know, we even got a couple of gigs. Which meant we then had to come up with the frigging name.
I mean, what a name. We got a load of unwanted shit because of that, I tell you. I mean, you won't believe it. But, you know, my mum says always do something you enjoy.
Controversial names aside, the four-man band managed to gain some success in their short time in 2018 and 2019. A few gigs here and there, a rather successful single in the indie scene, and the chance at a big record deal on the horizon.
Hey, right, it's Steve and Billy's turn now.
No, you haven't got my good side yet. What are you doing? They can wait.
It's fair to say, in a lot of people's eyes, Marvin became big-headed.
I am this band.
Marvin was unique. Lovely lad, but he just wasn't thinking of the band.
I am the best.
Oh, I wanted to rip his mustache off his slimy little face and shove it right up his arm.
I am a sex machine. Oh, he was a twat. I am Marvin Darling.
He's a virgin! Kill him!
After many arguments and spats, Marvin Darling split from the band and they went their separate ways. Goodbye, my friend.
The condition for the record deal, if I remember right, was to change the name. And Marvin will have it.
Yeah, he took us for mugs in the end. I mean, You know, he was a mug himself. I mean, did you see what he was wearing with his flowery f***ing shirt and porn star tash? Who does he think he is? He's not Freddie Mercury, is he?
At this point, the members who had become a sensation didn't know if they were going to carry on with music. That's when they were approached by a man who would change the course of music history, Jerry Bronstein.
Marvin and the old band name were a liability, so I never approached them at that point. When Marvin left, I saw the potential there.
With the help of Jerry, the Bouncy Castles skyrocketed in success. The business mindset of Bronstein decided to market each member differently. Billy was pushed as the camp frontman, Steve as the moody musician, and Danny was, well, Danny. Four years later, and after 47 weeks at number one, the Castles were at the peak of their fame.
And so I finally felt free that people could just stand there and just understand me. And I put my clothes on.
In 2023, interviews every other week, talk show appearances, and the success of Vaguely Human World Tour.
Oh, Danny. He was on everything on tour. Besides roller skates. But me, I got giddy off two Lemsips.
I don't know what you're about.
Hey, you don't?
No, I don't do drugs.
Jesus Christ, that fat f***ing bastard. I'm sure in his time he snorted off a f***ing Columbia.
You right?
Yeah?
Do you need a break?
Right, no. P*** off. I'll...
You know what I mean? I'd do with his suppositories now. I'd shove them right up it.
Come on, mate.
I'll knock you out, son.
Nevertheless, still a lovely, lovely bloke.
Then come on, mate! Get the f*** off me! I will torture you, Ben! I will cut you down with your f***ing bacon freezing!
After the cancellation of Society's Rejects on tour, cracks really began to show in the band, with it all exploding in late August and the band breaking up.
The world was so focused on Danny's issues and the tour being cancelled, we struggled to get any TV time at all.
Guys, great news, we've got TV time.
Do we?
Alan Carr.
Channel 4, lads! That's not bad!
Alan Carr, I said on the day we hired you, a list of rules, do you remember them? I am not going on any gay man's show, I want Graham Norton.
Okay. Okay. Bye, Billy. But,
please. No. Come on, lads!
Come on. Calm yourself down.
Okay, let's just mute that right there.
Right, stay there. Stay there, I've got this.
We wish you a merry... We wish you...
Mate, Steve?
A merry...
Steve, you're right.
Christmas.
Steve, mate, okay, let's just calm down a bit, yeah? Okay, there we go.
Alan Carr!
Yeah, that was bang out of order, that just bang out of order.
Do you think you'll carry on as the Bouncy Castles manager?
Are you kidding me? To be continued after about a century of editing, and you're gonna give us a to be continued? Are you?
You're still here? It's over. Go!